Get that shit off. Get that shit on. There we go.
Radiant team ban.
All right. Welcome back to the Mario Kart 2017 Destination Requiem. Or what are they called? Actually, Kappa Votes versus Fetty Attack 786. Best of one in the group remaining. A. This is going to be a pretty tough game, remaining. I think, for Fetty Attack 786. Obviously, these are the 1 and 2 reserve teams time from last year. So we'll see what the meta has done, what the talents changes have done, and then what a year's worth of practice has done. And we'll see these two teams face off in this best of 1 placement bracket. Should be here. Oh, okay. Alright, so first bans, like, gotta take the Tinker out. Wonder if we'll see a selection of more meta bans from this game. A Bloodseeker is banned once again, every game. Obviously, strongest hero in Dota 2 at the moment. What is the story with that? Is that just to amuse me as the caster, or I don't really see. I mean, Introduction of Shrines has made the hero just garbage. Like, no longer can you just chase someone across the map. Like, you just watch the shrine and you see all that. Really, really difficult higher levels play. The Fetty Attack 76 gonna ban the drag. Not quite the stomp hero that she was before. Quite a few nerfs remaining and changes and stuff, but with the right composition, yes, that hero is still, I guess, decent. Luna gonna get taken out of the pool then, so radiant, are they aiming for a Scylla Bear combo? Or I think we'll see Slardar for the offlane maybe? For, no, maybe Mavs will be like his Batrider again.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Axe.
Dire team pick.
Axe. Probably gonna be an offlaner there, I would think.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Much wow, much thoughts. We're gonna see a Treant Protector. Koof. He wants the Roman support, but maybe Slardar, maybe the Pudge. Something else along those lines. Ooh, Earth Spirit.
Dire team pick. Radiant team pick.
So Mats and Kalar, you're gonna alternate maybe between 1-2 slot. Juggernaut, obviously, if you played in the mid, you played in the safe lane. A very versatile hero. Does get called by Axe though.
Reserve time.
Alright, second pick now for Fetty Attack 786. Expect we'll see a support getting picked up, maybe.
Disruptor.
Ooh, that's nice. Disruptor axe combo. These guys, 20 attack 786. They're not building a team here. They're building a Darkmoon team. Anyway, second set of bands.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
That's really annoying.
Ban.
That'll fix it. Alright, Scylla Bear getting taken out, Ember getting taken out, Timber getting taken out. I mean, these bans are so on point, I think, for the current meta. I'm gonna dumpster that Shadow Fiend as well. Does Kappa Votes have an Invoker player? I don't think they do. Kingy, gonna maybe look for strong mid lane potential, Invoker, Storm Script, something like that, remaining. Maybe.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Alright, I probably see the offlaner coming out now, or a second support. I don't think we'll see their next Kali yet.
Ten seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Well, turns out they do have an Invoker player. I'm excited to see this. Alright, so it's going to be Invoker mid, Juggernaut safe lane, Lion to cover the Juggernaut in the safe lane, and then... So... Maybe the Call? I'm not sure they're going to pick up the Treant Protector.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Skywrath Mage.
Oh my god.
Templar Assassin.
Dire Team Ban.
Alright, final set of bans. Destination route, I'm looking to ban out a safe lane carry.
10 seconds remaining.
Kappa Votes even. God, why you change your name?
5 seconds remaining.
I'm gonna take a Morphling out. It's decent, it's pretty strong. Anti Mage could still be an option.
Radiant team pick.
Maybe a Void offlane for Destination right now. What else could they get? What else could they pick up? Ooh, Slark safe lane carry.
Dire team pick.
Darkseer.
Gonna go with the nerfed Darkseer. Alrighty then.
Prepare for battle.
Where's my tools? Where's my tools, guys? You look at their heroes and over click here we can get, right? Oh. Right, okay, let's do the rundown. So we've got no handshakes on the axe. Kubu Junior. I don't know what the fuck that's about. Kubu on the Slark, Kingy on the Templar Assassin, Alex on the Disruptor, and Nashbear on the Ogre Magi. Matsu gonna pick up the Juggernaut and take him to the safe lane. Koof gonna take the Evoker to mid. Zeniston on the Lion. Darkseer for Mats on the off lane. And Kaler on the Skyroth Mage. I'm not sure why we're paused. Let me just close this. Oh, white. Looks like Matsu calling for a smoke gank on the bottom rune. Oh, Volvo, with these servers, these connections, you're really spoiling us. The intensity building here, excitement. The one or two teams from last year's Murray Cup facing off against each other for the first time in the Murray Cup 2017. Oh, hang on a second, I'm actually just gonna maybe close off some of these windows. I actually lost sound. That's kind of annoying. Weird. Alright. Yay, sound has returned. Sorry about these delays, guys. Like I say, a bit of a power cut. Slark, not able to connect to the game because, you know, no power. On its way though, shouldn't be delayed for too much longer. All right.
Each blow sharpens my blade.
Cheeky bastards. Alright, okay. Let us begin. So, I mean, it seems like they decided not to go for... that smoke back. Basically, if someone was watching the stream, the pause was for so long that was going to be clearly obvious that that's, you know, what their plan was. So. Not that Fetty Attack even picked up on that, because if you look at the way their heroes are positioned, they wouldn't be ready for it anyway. Obviously, Slark has had some experience playing with Tree and Protectors and Monkey Kings. He's going to deforest that whole place.
Begins.
No early aggressive plays, it will be one for one across all of the runes there. Well, it's going to get top, QB going to get bottom, can he get top? strong lane here. Seniston, Keeler. Oh, Axe gonna have to be super, super careful on this lane. Spell damage gonna come in. Stun already, he's taking a lot of damage here. I think he wanted to try and get the D ward, but it just didn't happen. He's gonna manage to safely back off though, did tango on the way out just to keep himself tip top. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, D warding action happening, I guess. Kingy trying to get up in Kuth's face here, winning actually, I think, as far as last hits are concerned. Really tough matchup for the Invoker. The TA certainly a difficult situation, I think. Axe then, I think he went to the jungle and picked up a level 2 there. Just did this calp here. Oh, can't draw on the map, nice. Lol, where are her weapons? Oh, I don't think I've seen that helmet for Axe before. That's pretty cool, man. What the fuck? Oh, the Mask of a Thousand Faces, what? Or whatever. Like, Maths doesn't even have that sweet backpack or whatever it is for this dude. What the actual fuck? Yeah, we are back in the game, guys. It's only been 8 minutes of pauses so far. Should have like a little clock or something that ticks up. Oh, and Kufa actually managed to catch up really nicely on that mid lane farm. He's now going even Stevens. Yay! Alrighty. Was Kufa FK there? Harsh. Kufa, a little bit of trouble now just because of that. Not quite sure he was quite ready for the resume. No handshake, way of tea. No handshakes, way of tea. Okay. What are you doing, Axe? Get your tranquils. They're on the way. Oh, Zeniston with the cheeky rune snatch! Not much Axe can do about it. Zeniston actually gonna have to go back through the Axe now, and that is not gonna be a fun time for him, but Skywrath is there, the stun comes in. Axe starts to take some out, but surprise, Kingy's here. And Zeniston looks like the one who's gonna get his asshole fingered this time. Nice little haste rune to make that play available. So getting a better handle on his last hits now, but look at these denies, man. Holy crap, 19 and 16 versus 20 and 17. They just don't want these offlaners to get anything done. And, I mean, Axe, level 3 at 4 minutes, I don't expect him to kind of have a little bit more. I mean, he's not too far off the mark. And Nashbear actually joining him in that lane to maybe see if he could apply some pressure. Meanwhile, Maths, managing to get a good 15 last hits. Oh, Disruptor gonna have a little go here. The damage coming out, and Maths gonna try and push in on the Disruptor. Slark is getting harassed by the Stark shell in the lane, able to respond obviously with the knowledge that the Ogre Magi is top. Maths feels like a little bit more confident that he can make plays this deep into the lane. Super dangerous and vulnerable to rotations though. And meanwhile, in the mid, Kingy in a hell of a lot of trouble with that rotation from both Skywrath and Lion. Just going to boss him kind of like out of the lane. And Zeniston obviously looking for a little bit of revenge after that kill. Maths with enough mana to double Ion Shell despite the nerfs. Disruptor in behind. Looks for the position. Slark also kind of baiting him in, actually. Maths, though, spots the Disruptor. The glimpse is there. Slark is not aware, and he's actually gone around the other side. And, well, you know, that's a missed opportunity. I think they could have definitely had something there. Basically, just going to waste the time of the Slark, though. Both teams though showing really competent performances in lane, the two safe lanes. Kingy starting to struggle now in the mid lane as far as last hits are concerned, but I'm pretty sure if we look at the net worth, it will show a slightly different story. With that early pickup on the Lion, he should be in a pretty good place at the moment. Oh, Axe! Maths are going to use the ult and pick up that kill. Not quite pleased with that. A little bit extra farm. Did hit that level 6, and I mean, that was all Jagger. No. He did use a mango though for the ult. Nash Bear, look to see if he can punish an axe. Respawn already, so I mean they are in the lane, but the way the lane is at the moment, very well controlled. And oh, they're going to go in now on Kaelar. There is slow from the Ogre Magi, followed up by the stun. Axe comes in, and I expect to see. Doesn't have dunk yet, but they'll take that kill. Yep, that's extra XP going and gold going the way of both of them. And a Disruptor actually rotated up there at the same time. Meanwhile, Slark solo pushing the lane in. And with this aggressive trialing pressure on Matzo, Slark getting the space to actually move ahead. Oh, the Sunstrike! Ah! Just went on the Ion Shell. Pause? He wasn't disconnected because he was able to ult and try for the pounce, so I'm not sure what the situation is there. Is it a rage situation? I mean, he's in a really comfortable situation. Like, he has died, but doesn't seem that not bad. Alright guys, it's been 19 minutes, 21 minutes even, and we're at 7 minutes of game time. This is the kind of high-paced, intense action people expect from the Money Cup. Now, Matt's not going to go in onto the axe. Damage comes forward, but it's not going to be enough. He will manage to escape. Chooses to fire, bring the Ion Cannon down on the Disruptor, and the Disruptor will pay. 3 versus 3 situation there. I'm not sure Axe is going to get away. Matzo doesn't have enough mana for it. It doesn't result anyway, so on cooldown. I mean, given they were so deep into the lane and there was Trilane waiting for them, I don't think they did too badly just to lose the Disruptor off the back of that. Maths with the Invis rune. Oh, that sneaky. Sentry ward! Shit! So it will be the helm of the Dominator build for Matsu current meta.
Methinks you wanted that.
Axe actually finding Zenison on the back side there. And this danger courier, what the hell? Matsu was just like in amongst all three of them. And it's just like, well, not much we can do about that. TP response now from Lion. Yo, I think Lion's getting ready for the finger. Oh, he does not, he's level 3, 10 minutes in. That's not great, man. I have to say, that is not a great situation to be in. You should be finding your level 6 around about 10 minutes, Perch says, on supports. Oh, Alex, what are you doing? Oh, wait, no. Glimpses him back. Just kind of creating a little bit of space here. Axe looking for something, but now it's Axe versus 3. And sucked off, stunned. So much damage coming in. Matsu looking for that final hit. He's not got anything to follow up with, but he will. With the assistance of Kaylor, they will find the kill. And Slark going to come top, but no real point in that rotation. Unless he needed the secret shop anyway, I guess. A Shadow Blade, not too far behind, not too far away. We'll switch over to net worth now. I think it's going to give us a much better picture. Yeah, I mean, both Juggernaut and Invoker are sitting at the top of the table there. I guess Kuf went for a Midas. He did, so I mean, that's really kind of brought his farm back into the situation. Matsu under the tower, though, and they're going to have to be careful. Axe, though, like, he chose to go around the back instead of going around the front, and therefore wasn't able to find position on call on the Axe there. Safer decision making, but at the same time, less able to capitalize on it. So, talents coming up, and Kuf actually opted not to take his talent points at this point. King, you're going to pick up attack speed. Power treads on the Templar Assassin. That's interesting.
Money changes hands.
Well, glimpse back, but garbage. Oh, Zeniston is here. Oh, they drop around from the three of them, and Skywrath should get glimpsed back, but it's not going to happen. Trying to go in now onto Zeniston. The call is wildly out of position. They are now counter coming around from the side. MFC's TP'd up. There will be a VAC wall combo on three. Not too shabby. Matsu just going to come on in and help collect down the damage there. Even Kuf is throwing in some damage. And Kingy realizes his mistake. They find him with the stun. And they're all here anyway, so we might as well push this tower in.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Oh, Glimpse back though. Kuf in a lot of trouble here. There's no way he gets out of this, surely. Surely, where is your... It's coming, it's coming. Fire Blast is coming. Wow, they got 3 for the Invoker trade. I think that's still a good situation to be in. But Marth's in a little bit of trouble now as well. Slark finds him, but his position... wasn't the greatest. And he was scared of that iron shell, for sure. Real scared. Oh, these calls are just so bad. Like, as soon as he hits an actual call, it might be dangerous. Oh, on the backside though, he will pick up Zenith then, and now the glimpse back, and Marth's gonna have to try and sprint away. Marth's gonna try and join the fight, but... all 5 heroes for the Radiant in the dire jungle now. Marth's just gonna kite them around a bit. Oh, diving deep, Matsu opting not to TP well, don't you? Oh, what the f- what is this axe doing, man? Finger from Zenison on the Slark, as promised. Matsu gonna go down though to the axe. Nash Bear gonna be the follow-up kill in return. Skyroth gonna get that. The wow, so much damage coming through from the Skyroth there. Really nice position. Really nice use of his skills, getting both the kills here. That should finish up whatever item he was working on. Looks like he will get the Veil, and the Veil will be huge, absolutely huge for this team. Meanwhile, Kuf, a cheeky little push on bottom. There is going to be a TP response from Slark, and we'll see whether or not Kuf going to get caught out here. There we go. Are you actually joking me? No dust. Like, whatever. There's the ward though, and that will see him. He does have dust as well. So, and they will know because of this, the cold feet. The TP's coming through, and Kuf is out of there. That's Travels, by the way. He's finished up his Travels, and his minus at 15 minutes. So he did really well in that lane. So going deep, looking for this axe. Axe gonna block his own TA. Zenison looking for the finger, the stun comes through. Not really gonna do much, the battle hunger. Oh, Skyroth with some spells. Wow. What? Why did that do this so much damage? Did you get the, what? Oh, you got the Veil off, okay. Multicast coming in, all on to Invoker, great time to attack, he's going to go down, Matsu with the spin, just throwing out all the damages, Disruptor trying to get in there as well, there's only the Ogre. Alright, alright, so mid tower going to fall here probably, but Matsu already... excuse me. Already strongly pushing in this this bot one. That's fine. It's fine. It's fine. 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 Dire's middle tower is under attack. So, Petty Attack 76 trying to put some pressure on to match the pressure that Matsu put on bottom there. And a TP response now coming in from Matsu right in the middle. He is going to actually get caught a little bit out. There's the Vac wall on 3 though, and that's going to be a disaster. Finger comes out, 3 heroes down, and Slark actually taking a little bit more damage from this. Dire's middle tower. He's just going to actually run away until he's full health, it seems. Very balanced hero.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Oh, it's a little creep wave here, that's quite a strong creep wave. Tower has fallen.
Middle tower is under attack.
All the Radiant are here. TPN coming from Axe. Axe no blink though, so not able to make reaching. Oh, come on, Alex, be careful. Meanwhile, though, that will be one dead ass Skywrath match. Probably going to be quite happy with that. You know, he was on a little bit of a healing spree. Lass is really high on the net worth again. Like, I have to say, there's been a genuine strong improvement in Lass' play over the last sort of 4 months or so. Like, he was really good before, but I mean, nice. Yeah.
Top tower is under attack.
Looking for something here. Zenison waits in the trees. Koof to the back side there. Matsu now going to rotate in as well. Darkseer is in the bottom. Here comes the Skywrath Mage with... Wait. That was an ult from Jug. Oh, Koof, you though are going to be the target. He does manage to get the meatball out and he will destroy that Slark. TA just trying to chill. It's not happening. And now it's going to be a full team wipe, it seems. Just don't think Axe can get away. In comes the Veil. And yep. Stuns, magic damage, everything. Alex with the Disruptor combo. Oh, Matt's getting surged in. And the Glimpse comes through, but the spin blocks it. It's a shame because the ult just came off cooldown.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Where are the graph buttons now? Like,
double damage.
That's weird, man. That's really fucking weird. So it looks like Kingy is trying to build up his, he's finished actually, it's in his inventory, just needs to pick it up, so that will make a bit of a difference as far as fights and that are concerned. Hoot, is that he's trying to build towards a mech or pipe maybe. 21 minutes, 56 seconds, Matsu finishes up the Yasha. In a really strong position, 15 minutes, 50 level, 15, 23 minutes. A little bit under leveled, I think, with it. But that one team fight obviously put him way back on top of the net worth, and the difference between them is, it's got to be like 10-15k, right? Ags! Koof! That's 400, 500 gold to go. Oh, and Matsu actually trying for the solo Roshan here. Everyone else is smoked up around the pit. We're gonna go down. They are gonna spot that out. Kingy throws a trap and he's instantly aware that this shit is going down. He's like, oh no. Ah, nice. Disruptor comes in with the owl. Axe gonna blink in with the call. Finally got that blink finished up. Mats will pop the ult there and just saved himself. He had like no health at all. Roshan gonna go down in the meantime. The Dire actually gonna claim the kill and the Aegis. Only Slark survives then. We've got this Aegis, they're gonna now maybe look to push this high ground tower, open up the shrines. Reduce the map ability, movement ability of the Radiant team.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Oh my gosh. Well, that's going to be a set of racks as well. Axe, blink call on some creeps. Well played. Oh, bit of a multicast. Templar Assassin gonna get handled though. Vacuum into three. Kingy just gonna get actually destroyed here. Slark gonna chill on top of the Ion Cannon. And I think that's pretty much it. Slark has buyback. But we're getting into dangerous territory now. There's the buyback. He's going to try and find Matsu, and he will actually find him, it seems. Oh, wow. That's a huge boost for Slark. Everyone else is realizing that, shit, Slark is awake. We need to get the fuck out of here. And exfiltration. Not too bad at all. Not too bad at all. Trying to rush down onto Nashbear. Oh, blink forward. I'm gonna pick that kill up. Casually gonna push this bottom lane in. Not much they can do, I don't think, in response.
Bottom tower has fallen.
Ahem. Oh, Matt's over the cheeky out, gonna pick off one. They will pop that shrine, and now Snark taking a bit of damage. He is actually sarmed by that wave. He goes down. Kingy makes a bold move. I want to say bold, but really I mean stupid. And oh, but the axe actually doing a little bit of work there, and they will find him, Matsu, with that ult from the disruptor. Nice. Buyback from Kingy as well, and he's starting to wreak havoc a little bit on these back lines. But now he's taking a lot of damage, and I think that's going to be him going to go down there, maybe. Ooh, just about. Koof, absolutely destroying with the disruptor there on the backside. That's going to be a set of racks. Buybacks are down for everyone. Vac wall combo on two. That's going to help the barracks push in. Down goes Kingy. That was the end of. Oh, Koof fell as well. That's decent. Oh, the Slark ult is ready. Zenistan throws out the stun, keeps him in place for just a little while longer, and that rock will shoot secure the rock. Zenistan, though, with the brave blink forward. GG is called, though, at 30 minutes. And, you know, it just if you happen to be watching this, you play at any time. Dunk, Hill, Spicy Boys. Just soak in the score there. Alright, alright, alright. So we got the next game coming up, which is going to be Team Magnanimous versus Andrew Duncan Memorial Team.